Jane Austen, a name that resonates through the corridors of classic English literature, was an exceptional novelist known for her sharp wit, profound social commentary, and insightful exploration of the human heart. Born in the 18th century, Austen crafted novels that have remained timeless, offering a window into the manners, morals, and mores of her time. Despite the societal constraints of her era, she penned stories that continue to captivate and resonate with readers worldwide. This narrative will take you through her life journey from her modest beginnings to becoming one of the most celebrated authors in English literature. Jane Austen entered the world as the seventh child and second daughter of Reverend George Austen and Cassandra Lee Austen on December the 16th, 1775, in Steventon, Hampshire. Her family was closely knit, literate and creative, providing a fertile ground for her literary aspirations. The Austen household was lively, filled with energy of eight children, and steeped in an environment where reading and discussing books were a regular pastime. Jane's father was a clergyman and an amateur scholar who encouraged a love of learning in his children. The Austen siblings were tutored at home and benefited from access to their father's extensive library. Jane showed an early interest in literature, devouring classics and writing her own stories, poems, and plays from a young age. These, often humorous and satirical early works, reflect the keen observation and wit that would later define her novels. The family's financial situation was modest but stable, allowing the Austens the comforts of a middle-class life, without the extravagances enjoyed by the gentry. This middle ground gave Jane a unique vantage point from which she could observe and critique the social classes above and below her own. Her upbringing, surrounded by a loving family who valued education and the arts, played a crucial role in shaping her literary voice and worldview. Although formal education for girls was not a priority in the 18th century, Jane Austen's parents valued learning. They ensured she received a more comprehensive education than most women. At the age of seven, along with her sister Cassandra, Jane attended a boarding school where she likely studied French, spelling, needlework, dancing, and music. However, most of her education came from reading and writing at home, where she had access to classical literature, historical works, and contemporary novels. By her early teens, Jane began to craft her own works, which she termed juvenilia, comprising of short stories, theatrical plays, and verses. These pieces were brimming with parody and satire, targeting various literary conventions and the society of her day. Their spirited and comical nature hinted at the wit and insight that would later define her mature novels. As Austen entered adulthood, her family's financial circumstances fluctuated, influencing her personal life and literary pursuits. In 1801, after her father retired, the Austen family moved to Bath, a fashionable spa city. This period marked significant change for Jane, as she left the countryside she loved and temporarily ceased writing. However, this pause did not last long. After the death of her father in 1805, Jane, her sister, and their mother faced financial difficulties and moved several times. Despite these challenges, this period proved fruitful for Jane's writing. She began to revise her early novels, Sense and Sensibility, Pride and Prejudice, and Northanger Abbey, and started working on what would become Mansfield Park, Emma, and Persuasion. Her first published novel, Sense and Sensibility, appeared in 1811 and was followed by Pride and Prejudice in 1813 to commercial success and critical acclaim. These works, published anonymously, brought Austen modest fame, but she remained largely out of the public eye. Jane Austen's novels primarily explore themes of love, marriage, morality, and social mobility. Her keen observations of class distinctions, character development, and the pursuit of happiness resonate throughout her work. Pride and Prejudice portrays the intricate dance of courtship and the misunderstandings between Elizabeth Bennet and Mr. Darcy. Emma depicts the misadventures of matchmaking by its eponymous heroine. Mansfield Park explores morality and merit through the eyes of Fanny Price, an impoverished niece with wealthy relatives. Austen's works are celebrated for their irony, use of free indirect discourse and moral insight. She crafted detailed, lively portrayals of everyday life that highlighted women's dependencies, primarily financial, on marriage to secure social standing and economic security. In the last years of her life, Austen continued to write and revise her earlier works while her health declined. Seeking medical treatment, she relocated to Winchester, where she passed away on July 18, 1817, at the age of 41. Her brother Henry revealed her authorship posthumously, and her novels gained widespread popularity in the decades following her death. Today, Jane Austen stands among the elite in English literary history. Her novels have crossed linguistic borders into various languages and have been transformed into many films, TV series, and theatrical performances. Her keen insights into the complexities of human relationships and social class remain relevant, resonating with readers and audiences worldwide. The legacy of Austen reaches beyond her written works. Her life and literary contributions continue to be explored and honoured for their impact on literature, culture, and insights into England in the early 19th century. She remains a beloved figure, a symbol of wit, and a keen observer of the human heart. In the more than two centuries since her death, Jane Austen's novels have traversed the globe, finding a home in readers' hearts from varied cultures and backgrounds. Her sharp wit, keen observations, and timeless insights into human nature and society's constraints have made her works beloved classics, studied by scholars and cherished by casual readers alike. Austen managed to capture the essence of her time while simultaneously speaking to universal themes of love, respect, and individuality that transcend the confines of her historical period. Though she lived a relatively short and sheltered life, Austen's understanding of human emotions and social dynamics was profound. Her novels, initially written for the amusement of her family and friends, have become seminal texts, dissecting the incidental of 19th century English society with humour and precision. The irony that she wove into her narratives remains biting, and her critiques of social class and gender dynamics are still relevant. As we reflect on Austen's life and body of work, we are left to ponder, what new understandings and appreciations can we gain from her novels in today's world? And how might her incisive observations about her society prompt us to examine our own? In a world vastly different yet strangely similar to Austen's, her stories continue to provoke thought, elicit laughter, and inspire many adaptations. So as we close this chapter on Jane Austen's life, we are left with a lingering question. How would Austen have written about the complexities and challenges of our modern world? And what can we learn from applying her sharp wit and keen social insights to our contemporary lives?